Listen it. His face was white and peaked. His eyes were hollows of madness. His hair is like mildly hay. But he loved the landlord's daughter, the landlord red-lipped daughter. Dumb as a dog, he listened and hear the robber say. Oh, not bad, I think so. Mike is free.
Okay, Chip and Dale, right. One thing I like is enthusiasm, okay, and confidence. Very well done. Now, if you record in your own voice, you'll find just what little things you made in error. Now, the ones I've noted and need comment on is the simple fact that you have a standard problem with the ED endings of words. Now, if you remember, friends, that most ED endings, or for that matter, ES endings, are not pronounced. The ending ED is not pronounced as a separate syllable, okay? Most of them. When they are, you'll become familiar with, okay? Right, so the words like bard, peaked, and listened. You don't say barred or peaked or listened. So remember that, Chippendale, the ED endings. And the other word, of course, is that in British English we use platting. We say platting. I think Americans might use plate. But we have another meaning for plating, which it has to do with heavy engineering and the flow of metals on metal. Okay, but I'm not going to go into that. Well, at one time, Tuan, I used to be a teleprinter operator. Okay, so I did have those skills, but as I'm now getting old, and my fingers are like sausages, I don't quite type as fast as I used to. Okay, right. Okay, and now then, we're going to pass the mic to our old friend, well, young friend, Camel. It's your mic, Camel. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Starik. I am an old man, okay, not young. Over the cobbles, he clattered and clashed in the dark in yard, and he tapped with his whip on the shutters, but all was locked and barred. He whistled a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess, the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. Dark in the old inn yard stable wicked, creaked, where Tim the ostler listened. His face was white and peaked. His eyes were hollows of madness. His hair like mouldy hay. But he loved the landlord's daughter, landlord's red-lipped daughter, dumb as a dog. He listened, and he heard the robber say. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Camel, well, very nicely done. Nice, clear voice you have. Very nice pace, okay? And easily understood elucidation. Very nice indeed, enunciation, very nice. Now, as you see, Tuan has told you we don't use foreign text. Okay, we only use English text in here. You can say hello or good morning in your own language, of course. But other than that, we don't use chat in our own language. We don't chat in English. We try to concentrate on the matter in hand. Okay. Now, I noticed that, where is it? Let me just have a look. I saw it in the text. yes, David. David said that words ending with D, we pronounce the E. No, we don't pronounce the E, okay? It's silent, although we take note of it, okay? It's not pronounced, okay? Now, the only time we pronounce the ED ending is when we have a different form, okay? You can be, you learnt something, or you are a learned person. Notice the difference, okay? So there are those occasions, okay? And of course, the E at the end is a silent E in words, of course, that give us a particular pronunciation. However, we deal with that on another occasion. Right, well, thank you for that reading. Very nice indeed. Okay. Okay. I know we don't pronounce the ED except in special occasions. Okay. No, we don't pronounce the E. Where do you pronounce the E in the word, let's see, let's have a little short discussion on like. Where do we pronounce the E in that? Okay, take the word like, David. Tell me, where do we pronounce the E? Where, I didn't say it was needed, I said, where do you pronounce it? Okay, the E gives us a pronunciation. Okay, thank you for that. My name is Luke. Hello, Luke, please. Okay. Thank you, Luke. It's your mic. Okay, Luke. Well, there's no reply. I'm sorry about this, but let's give you one more chance. So, Luke, we don't use cameras in here. QTRU, okay, Kutronks, we don't use cameras. So could you please switch it off, friend? Otherwise, I'm going to take your hand down again. Okay, please don't use the camera. Right. Okay, well, let me, I guess I'm going to have to. Right, now it's taken him away. Let's go down to. So now, Luke, you've just read it. Well, if you've heard me, of course, let's try again. Let's try. Luke, would you get take that? Please, your mic. Okay, well, my name is Luke, is a ghost figure, is a ghost name, I see. Okay. So let's pass the mic to our old friend. I see, well, I beg your pardon, I see they're in Gaza. I see Gracie, your mic. I hope the battery's okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Derek. And the batteries are not okay, as usual. All the couples he clattered and crashed in the darkened yard, and he tapped with his whip on the shutters, but all was locked and barred. He whistled a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter? Piss! The landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red long knot into her long black hair. And dark in the old inn yard, the stable wicket creaked, where Tim the ostler listened. His face was white and peaked, his eyes were hollows and madness, his hair like mouldy hay. But he loved the landlord's daughter, the landlord's red-lipped daughter, dumb as a dog, He listened and he heard the robber say, so whatever he says, he won't listen. Yeah, Mike, are you up to my view?
Thank you, I see. Well, you sound okay. The batteries seem to be running okay. Okay, good luck there, I see. I hope it works well. Now then, there were two words that need comment. The word, of course, the name is Bess. Bess. The landlord's daughter, Bess. And the other little point was the definite article, the pronunciation of the definite article in the ostler. Notice it's a vowel that follows, a vowel sound. Remember, it's the sound that follows the definite article, decides the pronunciation of it. The ostler, okay. Otherwise, that was nicely done. Thank you, Icy. Great. Okay, now I'm going to put up a new text. Unless, have you read that, Samurai? Have you read this one? Have you read it, Samurai? You need to. Okay. Samurai, your mic.
Hi everyone, I'm going to read. Over the cables he cluttered and clashed in the dark and yard. And he tapped with his whip on the shutters. But all was locked and buried. He whistled a tune to the window. And who should be waiting there? But the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Beth, the landlord's daughter, blatant, a dark red love knot into her long black hair, and dark in the old inn-yard a stable wicked creaked where Tim, the ostler listened. His face was white and beaked. His eyes were hollows and madness. His hair like motley hay. But he loved the landlord's daughter. The landlord's red-lipped daughter. Dumb as a dog, he listened, and he heard the robbers say, thank you.
Thank you, Samurai. Well, that was a brave effort, and thank you for that. Now, I noticed you had the Middle Eastern little problem, where we have that slight ending problem, landlords. Okay, when we have the double consonant ending, especially in things like next or text, the XT and maybe the S if it's the plural, there is a tendency by our friends from Middle East, Arab and the like, to try to put a schwa vowel sound between the final two letters. And now that occurred, I noticed, between, in your case, just once, very faintly, in but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess. The landlord's daughter. Notice the z at the end. Okay, it's the possessive, and it's telling us it's the daughter of the landlord. Okay, but it has to be heard. Okay, it has to be heard. A stable wicket is a small little gate. Okay, a little stable wicket. Now, a stable door is where you perhaps see horses in the stable, and the door is split into two parts. So you can open the top part and the horse can stick his head out and say hello to you. Okay. Now that was very nicely done, and there was just one little other point. That was the definite article again, the old inn yard, okay, the old. And just the last little point was his eyes were hollows of madness. Okay, of, I didn't hear of, okay. Didn't hear that preposition. Okay, his eyes were hollows of madness. Very nice indeed, otherwise, thank you. Okay, Golden, it's your mic.
Thank you so much, Starik. Before to read, guys, can you hear me well? Okay, thank you. Over the cupboards, they clattered and clashed in the dark in yard, and he taped with his weapon the shattered, but all was blocked and barred. He whistled a torn window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess, the landlord's daughter, plaiting in a dark red love knot into her long black hair, and dark in the old inn-yard, the stable wicket, cricket, where Tim the ostler, listened. His face was white and peaked. His eyes were hollows of madness. His hair like moldy. Hey, but he loved the landlord's daughter. The landlord's red-lipped daughter. Dumb as a dog, he listened, and he heard the robber say, okay, thank you for listening. You can correct me, sorry.
Okay, wow, very nice indeed. A very careful reading. Okay, you got that through very well indeed. Now, there was one word, and it was unusual for you because most of the words you had correct. It was just that one word, and you gave it with the ED ending sound. Creaked, you said creaked. But all the others, peaked, okay, you had it correct. Clashed, clattered, barred, whistled. You had all of those correct, except that one word, creaked. Well done. Rashid, salam. Great to see you, Rashid. Thank you. Right. After Lolo, I'll put up another text. Here is the word, the text. And thank you, Lolo, your mic.
Hi.
Let's try again. It's Lolo. It's your mic.
Hi, can you hear me? Hello? Okay. Over the cobbles, he clattered and clashed in the dark inn yard. And he tapped with his whip on the shutters. But all was locked and barred. He whistled a tune to the window. And who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Beth. The landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. And dark in the old inn-yard stable wicket creaked, where Tim the ostler listened. His face was white and peaked. His eyes were hollows of madness. His hair like moldy hay. But he loved the landlord's daughter. Thank you.
Okay, Lolo. Well, very nice indeed. A very good reading. Now, you've got a nice reading of present to hear. Your pronunciation of the definite article each time was very good. I have no other comment. Very nice indeed. Okay. Now then, I'm going to put up a new text. Okay, here it is. We're going to find out what the robber said to his young lady. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart. I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning light. Yet, if they press me sharply and harry me through the day, then look for me by moonlight. Watch for me by moonlight. I'll come to thee by moonlight, though hell should bar me. He rose upright in the stirrups. He scarce could reach her hand, but she loosened her hair in the casement. His face burnt like a brand as the black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast. And he kissed its waves in the moonlight. Oh, sweet black waves in the moonlight. Then he tugged at his rein in the moonlight and galloped away to the west. Okay, band, it's yours. Thank you.
Okay, thanks so much for the test. Even though I didn't understand much of the words of the text, I'm just gonna try to read. One kiss. My bony sweetheart, I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning lights. Yet, if they press me sharply and harry me through the day, then look for me by moonlight. Watch for me by moonlight. I'll come to thee by moonlight, though hell should bar the way. He rose upright in the stirrups. He scarce could reach her hand, but she loosened her hair in the casement. His face burnt like a brand as the black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast. And he kissed its waves in the moonlight. Oh, sweet black waves in the moonlight. Then he tugged at his rein in the moonlight and galloped away to the west. Okay, thank you so much. There's no topic for discussion. We're just reading this story. Mike, is back to you, Starik. Thank you.
Okay, well, band, that was a great reading. Beautifully done, okay. A little staccato, by that I mean a little jerky, okay, but you'll be able to smooth that out so it becomes a nice, steady flow, okay. Very nice. And I have no corrections. Well done. Right, it's Tuan. Okay, young Tuan, it's your mic. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. It's me again. Am I audible? Yes, okay. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart. I'm after the prize tonight.
Hello?
But I shall be back with the yellow gold before morning light. Yet, if they press me sharply and harry me toward the day, then look for me by moonlight. Watch for me by moonlight. I will come to thee by moonlight. Through hell should bar the way.
Ừ, đừng tên là cá từ đừng
he rose upright in the stairroom.
Ở đường trên
he
là đất sét một cái, có
cái
gạch là đất sét.
Hand,
but she biết hai cái thôi. Ở đất sét thì cái là
in the casement. His face burned like a brand as the black cascade.
Lúc chiều anh nghe thằng đoàn nó nói gì gì đó thôi, anh nghe
bằng
máng thế thôi, anh nghe bằng máng thế làm à.
Over his breath. After his
đoàn
kiss,
nó mới ra ngoài rồi.
His wave in the moonlight. Oh, sweet back wave in the moonlight. Then he took it at his brain in the moonlight and got it away to the west. Okay, I'm done. So, mic is for you, Mr. Starik.
Okay, Tuan, thank you for that. That was a nice read, nicely done, good, confident reading. Now, there were a few words that need comment, Tuan. First of all, try to make sure that you don't make an abbreviated form into its long form. And by that I mean in the fourth or fifth sentence. You can see, watch for me by moonlight, I'll come to thee, not I will. Okay, it's I'll come to thee by moonlight. So although it means I will or I shall, you have to pronounce it as you see it. Okay, remember that. Now the other word were, though hell should bar the way, though. And then you had that little problem with the ed ending, loosened, tugged, galloped. Remember, not loosened, tugged or galloped. It's loosened, tugged and galloped. Okay, thank you, Tuan, nicely read. A7. Well, I only use A4. A7, it's your mic. Okay, A7, well, I hope you're trying to find where the microphone is. And can you answer me in the text? Can you hear me, A7? Okay, Tuan, time for bed or just rest, okay. Tuan, it's very nice to hear you every day, of course, well done. Okay, A7, are you using a computer? Or an iPhone, you are. Well, do you know how to use the mic? Okay, A7, it's your mic. Thank you.
Is my sound okay now? Hello? Okay, I will start now. One kiss, my bonnie sweetheart, I'm after a bride tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning light. Yet, if the breath me sharply and hurry me through the day, then look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight. I will come to thee by moonlight, though hell should bar the way. He rose upright in the stirrups. He scarce could reach her hand, but he loosened her hair in the casement. His face burned like a brand as the black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast, and he cast its waves in the moonlight, oh sweet black waves in the moonlight. Then he tugged at his rein in the moonlight and galloped away to the west.
Okay, A7, thank you. Right, well, thank you for that. Now, you go a little fast. You're going a little too fast. Now, of course, you may well be quite a competent reader, but try to slow down, because by slowing down, you can stop some of the mistakes you make, okay? Now, the mistake you made, first of all, was the word they. We didn't hear it correctly in the second sentence. Okay, yet if they press me sharply. Yes, okay, A7, that's fine. We're all nervous, okay? I'm a nervous person. You can hear it. No, I'm not nervous, okay. Right. Although that was a good reading, A7, so don't worry. Right, so if they press me sharply, and then I notice you inserted a word repetitively. You said, then look for me by the moonlight. Watch for me by the moonlight. Now you can see that there's no definite article, is there? There's no the. Now one of the reasons for that is, of course, that you will have not been going, you will have been going a little fast, and the automatic assumption is that the definite article should be in there, but it's not. So remember, don't insert words that are not, okay. And the last word was, yes, well, that was it. Very well done otherwise, and welcome to the room. Thank you. Chippendales, it's your mic.
All right, thank you. One kiss, my bonnie sweetheart. I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with her gold before the morning light. Yet they press me sharply and harry me through the day. Then look for me by the moonlight. Watch for me by the moonlight. I will be come to tree the moonlight. Through his shoe barred the way. He rose upright in the stirrups. His scarce could reach her hand, but he loosened her hair in the casement. His face burned like a brand, as the black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast, and he kissed the waves in the moonlight. Oh, sweet black waves in the moonlight. And he tugged his rein in the moonlight and galloped away to the west. Okay, mic is free, guys.
Right, Chippendales. Well, first of all, the first little error, okay, is the word you missed, okay. I shall be back with the yellow gold. Now, you just said yellow. There was no gold mentioned by you at all. So you must have enough, okay. Right, yellow gold. You missed that word. And then there was another word. If they press me sharply. Yes, and then we got to the watch for me by moonlight. Now, it's not the moonlight. No, that's wrong. Watch for me by moonlight. Okay, look for me by moonlight. Watch for me by moonlight. I'll come to thee by moonlight. Not the moonlight. Okay. Okay, remember that, friend. Don't insert words that aren't there. And there was one other little comment, and that is on the word loosened. Okay, you said loosened. Okay, well done, Chippendale. Thank you. Now then, it's Rashid. Thank you, Rashid. It's your mic. Okay, well, it looks like Rashid is not with us. Perhaps he's lost us. I wonder, can you hear me, Rashid? Can you hear me? Avast. Now then, we're not going to tell you again, are we? Avast, you know what's what. Okay, thank you. Rash, okay, Rashid, it's your turn, your time, your mic. Thank you.
Hello, hello, everybody. Am I audible? Thank you much, Mr. Story, this exercise. Thank you all. Okay, let me participate and read the text. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart, I am after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning light. Yet, if they press me sharply and hurry me through the day, then look for me by moonlight. Watch for me by more light, I'll come today by more light, though hell should bar the way. He rose upright in the stirrups, scarce could reach her hand, but she loosened her hair in the casement. His face burnt like a brand as the black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast, and he kissed it, its waves in the moonlight. Oh, sweet blaze. Okay, this is the end for Mr. Skivermash. Your mic, thank you very much.
Okay, Rashid, very nice indeed, thank you. Now I'm putting up a new text, okay? I see Golden's there. By the way, this is quite a story of great love of this young girl for this robber, the highwayman. Right. He did not come in the dawning. He did not come at noon. And out o' the tawny sunset, before the rise o' the moon, when the road was a gypsy's ribbon, looping the purple moor, a red coat troop came marching.
Oh,
King George's men came marching up to the old inn door. They said no word to the landlord. They drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt at her casement with muskets at their side. There was death at every window, and hell at one dark window, for Bess could see through the casement the road that he would rock. Golden, it's your mic.
Okay,
thank you so much.
Có cái bên trên là của cát, cái bên dưới là của sét. Cái nào không có là hai cái giống nhau.
Seconds. Just to repost the text.
Một cái R, một cái này F ý. Năm hùng.
He did not care.
Năm tỏ.
In the dawning. He did not come at noon, and at our tawny sunset, before the rise of the moon, when the road was gypsy's ribbon, looking the purple moon or moor, a red coat troop came marching, King George's men came marching after the old inn door. They said no word
Thank you, Golden. Right, just 2 points. The old inn door. Okay, the old inn door. Okay. The old inn door. And the other word was gagged. Gagged. They gagged his daughter. Okay, well, very well done, Golden. Apart from that, it was well done. Thank you. Lolo, it's your mic. Thank you.
Hello, can you hear me? Okay. He didn't come in the dawning. He didn't come at noon. And out of the tawny sunset, before the rise of the moon, when the road was a gispy through ribbon, looping the purple moor, a red coat troop came marching, marching, marching. King George's men came marching up to the old inn door. They said no word to the landlord. They drank his ale instead. But they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt at her casement, with muskets at their side. There was death at every window, and hell at the text. The text is not complete. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Lolo. Thank you very much indeed. Now, there was just one little point in your reading, which was excellent. Your reading was very good. Right in the first sentence, okay, he did not come in the dawning. He did not come at noon. Now, you told us he didn't come in the dawning. He didn't come at noon. Notice the difference. Now remember, he did not come. That's what's written. Exactly what's written, you read. Okay. Thank you very much, Lola. Great reading that. Samurai, it's your mic.
Hi, everyone. I will try to read it. He did not come in the dawning. He did not come at noon. And out of the tawny sunset, before the rise of the moon, when the road was gypsy, the ribbon, lobbing the purple moon, a red coat troop came marching. King George's men came marching up to the old inn door. They said no word to the landlord. They drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt at her casement with muskets at their side. There was death at every window, and hell at one dark window. Forbes could see through the casement the road that he would ride. Thank you.
Thank you, Samurai. Great reading. Now then, a very good reading that. Now, there was a couple of words. The old inn door, okay? Up to the old inn door. And one other little point, and it was a little point, and that was your pronunciation of the CH in marching, not marching, march, not marsh, march, marching is the CH sound, marching. Okay, otherwise that was a great reading, thank you. Valkyria, hello Valkyria, well done, thank you for that. Your mic, thank you Valkyria.
Thank you. You listen to me? The audio is okay? Thank you. He did not come in the dawning. He did not come at noon and out of the tawny sunset before the rising of the moon, when the road was a gypsy rainbow, looping the purple moor. A radical troop came in marching, King George's men came in marching up to the old inn door. They said no word to the landlord. They drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt at her casement with muskets at their side. There was death at every window and hell at one dark window. For Bess could see through the casement the road that he would ride. Thank you.
Okay, Val, thank you, Valkyria. Very nice indeed. Very nice reading. Very clear audio you have. A lovely reading voice. And thank you for that. Great. Now, just the one little point, and that was where you became a little vague from here, in the second sentence, when the road was a gypsy's ribbon looping the purple moor, okay? When the road was a gypsy's ribbon. Okay, otherwise that was great. No, so you got that okay, gagged. You had that okay. Gagged, yes. Well done. Chippendale, you've read this, haven't you? Have you read it? No, you haven't. Okay. Okay, Chippendale, it's your mic.
Sorry.
All right. I am audible, please. One more type, please. Okay, thank you, guys. He did come up in the dawning. He did come up at the noon, and out the old tawny sunset before the rise of the moon. When the road was a gypsy's rainbow, looping the purple moor. A red coat troop came marching. King George's men came marching up to the old inn door. They said no word to the landlord. They drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt her casement with muskets at their side. There was death at every window, and hell at the one dark window, for Bess could see through the casement the road that he would ride. Thank you, guys. Mike is free.
Okay, Chippendale, very nice indeed. However, you gave us totally wrong information in your first sentence. You said, he did come in the dawning. He did come at noon. Well, when we read it again, we can see that he did not come in the dawning. He did not come at noon. Okay. Right. And just one other little point. The old indoor. Remember the definite article. The old indoor. The, not the. Thank you for that. That was great. Okay. Thank you, Chippendale. Right. Now I'm going to go into put the text up again for Sabur. Hello, Sabur. I don't remember working with you before, but welcome to our room, and I hope you enjoy your visit. Your mic.
Hello, guys. Can you hear me? Yeah. Thank you for your welcoming, and I will try to read this text. He did not come in the dawning. He did not come at noon and out of the downy sunset before the rise of the moon. When the road gives this ribbon, loving the purple moor, a red coat troop came marching, King George's men came marching up to the old indoor. They said no word to the landlord. They drank his ale instead. But they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt at her casement with muskets at their side. There was death at every window and hell at one dark window, for death could see through the casement road that he would ride.
Okay, well, Sabur, thank you very much indeed, and great welcome to you. Now, just one little point, just to let you know, you're too close to the microphone. Remember, friends, never speak into the microphone. Put the microphone under your chin or to the left or right of your face, okay? The microphone doesn't need you to speak into it. Now then, Sabur, you had two little points. I understand you have a little problem with the TH sound. Now, the TH sound in English is almost unique to English, and it can be difficult for some of our friends, purely because of their own language interference. Now, you, Sabur, pronounce it z, with a sort of a z sound. It is, of course, the or the. So that's something you need to practice, Sabur. And the other word was, you gave us the hard G instead of the soft, okay? That, as you can see, it's the gypsy's ribbon, okay? The road was a gypsy's ribbon. Otherwise, that was nicely done. And thank you, Sabur. Right, I'm putting up a new text. I see it's Lolo. And here we go. They had tied her up to attention with many a sniggering jest. They bound a musket beside her with the barrel beneath her breast. Now keep good watch, and they kissed her. She heard the dead man say, look for me by moonlight, watch for me by moonlight. I'll come to thee by moonlight, though hell should bar the way. Can't you see the text? You can't see that text, oh dear. Something's wrong. Just a moment, friends. I don't quite know what. Oh, my goodness. What's going on here? Let's see if I can change that. See if I can change it. That might help. Let's see. Yes, Right, well, what about that? Can you see that? Can you see anything at all, friends? Nothing, oh dear me. Well, I'll have to pass over that one and go on to the next one. My goodness. I'm sorry about this, friends. If I was by myself, I'd be swearing. I do apologize. Right, here it is. Okay, now of course we've got one verse missing, but however, the girl, of course, Bess, has been tied up to the end of her bed, and she's got a musket, a rifle, that's right pointing up to her breast, and here she is trying to warn her lover, who is coming up, the highwayman is coming up the road in the dark. The tip of one finger touched it. She strove no more for the rest. Up, she stood up to attention with the barrel beneath her breast. She would not risk their hearing. She would not strive again, for the road lay bare in the moonlight. Blank and bare in the moonlight, and the blood of her veins in the moonlight throbbed to her love's refrain. Tlot tlot, tlot tlot, had they heard it, the horse hoofs ringing clear. Tlot tlot, tlot tlot, in the distance, were they deaf that they did not hear? Down the ribbon of moonlight, over the brow of the hill, the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. Red coats looked to their priming. She stood up straight and still. Okay, I'm reading the wrong text. Agent. Okay, Lolo, it's your mic. Thank you.
Hello, can you hear me? Well, the tip of one finger touched it. She strove no more for the rest. Up. She stood up to attention with the barrel beneath her breast. She would not risk their hearing. She would not strive again, for the road lay bare in the moonlight, blank and bare in the moonlight, and the blood of her veins in the moonlight throbbed to her love's frame. Tlot, 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 tlot. Had they heard it? The horse hoofs ringing clear, tlot, 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 in the distance. Were they deaf that they did not hear? Down the ribbon of moonlight, over the brow. Thank you.
Okay, well, that was a great reading, Lolo, particularly good because you gave us, we could hear the questions. You heard the questions as you read it. Very well done. A great expression you put into that. You got a clear reading voice as well. Nice to hear that. Okay. So, Samurai, it's your mic. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm going to read it. The tip of one finger touched it. She strove no more for the rest. Up, they stood up to, to attention with a barrel beneath her breast. She would not risk their hearing. She would not strive again. For the road lay bare in the moonlight, blank and bare in the moonlight, and the blood of her veins in the moonlight throbbed to her love's refrain. Tlot, 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 tlot. Had they heard it? The horse hoofs raining clear. Tlot, 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 tlot. In the distance, where they did that they didn't hear? Down the robin of moonlight, over the brow of the hill, the highwayman came riding. The redcoats locked to their priming. She stood up straight and still. Thank you all for hearing me.
Thank you, Samurai. Right. Had they heard it? Okay, not heard it. You said it correctly the first time, and then you corrected yourself. Had they heard it? Very good. Heard it. The horse hoofs. The horse hoofs ringing clear. Okay. And were they deaf? Deaf, not deep. Deaf. And brow. The brow of the hill. Very nice indeed. Thank you for that. Nice reading that. Okay, Valkyrie, your mic. Okay, well, Valkyrie, I'm afraid that I've had to take your microphone away because we can't hear anything at all. There was no sound. Now, you've worked it okay before. I wonder what's happened. Put your hand up again, and if you're ready, and I'll call you up, Valkyrie. Okay. Right, okay, you're ready. Thank you. Valtria, your mic.
Okay, now. The tip of one finger touched. She strove no more for the rest. Up, she stood up to attention, with the barrel beneath her breast. She would not risk their hearing. She would not strive again, for the road lay bare in the moonlight, blank and bare in the moonlight, and the blood of her veins in the moonlight throbbed to her love's refrain, trot, 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 trot. Had they heard it? The horse hoofs ringing clear, trot, 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 in the distance. Were they deaf that they did not hear? Down the rainbow of moonlight, over the brow of the hill, the highwayman came riding. The redcoats looked to their priming. She stood up straight and still. Thank you.
Okay, Valkyrie. Well, just 2 points. They are of a similar nature. Touched. Okay, touched. Sorry about that, I had to sneeze. Just the two words, touched. Okay, remember I didn't hear the ED. Touched and throbbed. Throbbed. Okay, but a nice reading there. Thank you. Right, I'm putting up the new text. Very near the end here. Remember that clot clot. It's a little faster and it's meant to replicate the sound of the horse's hoofs. Clot 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 clot. Right, here we are, and you can see that text, I hope. Okay, here we go. Yes, well, you'll be able to read in a moment, maybe, okay. Clot, clot, in the frosty silence. Clot, clot, in the echoing night. Nearer he came and nearer. Her face was like a light. Her eyes grew wide for a moment. She drew one last deep breath. Then her finger moved in the moonlight. Her musket shattered the moonlight, shattered breast in the moonlight, and warned him with her death. He turned, he spurred to the west. He did not know who stood bowed with her head o'er the musket, drenched with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it. His face grew grey to hear how Bess, the landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, had watched for her love in the moonlight and died in the darkness there. Thank you, Chippendale. It's your mic.
All right, thank you. Clot, clot in the frosty silence. Clot, clot in the echoing night. Nearer he came and nearer. Her face was like a light. Her face was like a light. Her eyes grew wide for a moment. She drew the last deep breath. Then her finger moved the moonlight. Her musket shattered the moonlight, shattered her breast in the moonlight, and warned him with her death. He turned, he spurred to the west. He did not know who stood bowed with her over the musket, drenched with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it. His face grew gray to hear how Bess, the landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, had watched her love in the moonlight and died in the darkness there. Okay, mic is free.
Okay, Chippendale, right, now then. Just a couple of little points. You missed out the word one, okay? She drew one last deep breath. And then we had the little problem with the ED endings of shattered, okay? Her musket shattered the moonlight, shattered her breast in the moonlight, not shattered, okay, shattered, and bowed, and the other little pronunciation was heard and hear, okay, not till the dawn he heard it, his face grew grey to hear, okay, thank you, that was great. Very nicely done, Chippendale. Golden, it's your mic.
Thank you. Clot, clot, in the frosty silence. Clot, clot, in the echoing night. Nearer he came and nearer. Her face was like a light. Her eyes grew wide for a moment. She drew one last deep breath. Then her finger moved in the moonlight. Her mask shattered. The moonlight shattered her breast in the moonlight and warned him with her death. He turned his spur to the west. He did not know who stood forward with her head or the mask drenched in her own red blood. Not yet the dawn, he heard it. His face grew gray to hear how best. The landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, he had watched for her love in the moonlight and died in the darkness there. Thank you for listening. Oh yeah, still. Okay, so thank you for listening. You can correct me.
Yes, okay. Well, that was a great reading. That really was. Beautifully done. Now, one word. He did not know who stood bowed. Okay? Bowed with her head or the musket. Otherwise, that was very nicely done. Well done, Gordon. Thank you. Now, Mehdi, it's your turn. So, Mehdi, it's your mic.
Hello, guys. Tlat in the frosty silence, tlat in the echoing night. Nearer he came and nearer her face was. Her eyes grew wide for a moment. She drew one light. Then her finger moonlight. Her mouth shattered. Rest in the moon and warmth. He turned his spurred to the west. He did not know who stood bowed with her head over the mask, drenched with her own red blood. Not yet the dawn, he heard it. His face grew gray to hear how best the landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, had watched for her love in the moonlight and died in the darkness there. Thank you.
Okay, now that was a nice, confident read. Okay, very well done. Just a couple of standard problems. The ED ending of the word drenched. Okay, drenched and watched. Not drenched or watch it. Okay, drenched and watched. Okay, now. His face grew grey to hear. And that was, otherwise, that was a good reading, a very careful one as well. Thank you. Okay, Sabur, it's your mic.
Hi again. Everybody can hear me? Okay. Trot. In the frosty silence, blood in the evening night. Nearer he came and nearer. Her face was like a light. Her eyes grew white for a moment. She drew one last deep breath. Then her finger moved in the moonlight. Her musket shattered. The moonlight shattered. Her breast in the moonlight. And warning his hair this. He turned his part to the west. He didn't know who stood bowed with her head or the musket, drenched with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it. His face grew gray to hear how this the landlord's daughter. The landlord's black-eyed daughter had watched for her love in the moonlight and dead in the darkness there.
Thank you, Sabor. Right, okay, another nice reading. Now, I've mentioned before, so I won't do it again, okay, within the emphasis. That is your pronunciation of the TH. You really must get that correct, okay? You do say it with a Z sound, okay? The. Most important. The other word was one word, and that was the word bow. He did not know who stood bowed with her head or the musket. Thank you for that. Okay. The white road smoking behind him, and his rapier brandished high. Blood red were his spurs, ere the gold noon. Wine red was his velvet coat, when they shot him down on the highway. Down like a dog on the highway, and he lay in his blood on the highway, with a bunch of lace. With the white road smoking behind him, and his rapier brandished high. Okay, brandished high. A little awkward, that word, isn't it? Okay, brandished high. And the little eye itself, blood red were his spurs. You can say in the golden moon. Okay, that's just the poet playing with the word. In the golden noon. Well done, and thank you. New man, it's your mic.
Hi guys, check my sound please. Okay, brother, sorry. Deck. He spurred like madman, shrieking a curse to the sky. With the white road smoking behind him and his rapier. wrong, wrong check. High, blood, red, where he spares. The golden moon. Wine red was his velvet coat. When they shot him or shot him down on the highway. Down like a dog on the highway. And he lay in his blood.
Cũng do game đó phát triển luôn. Là chúng ta sẽ chơi demo thôi. Còn lại chúng ta phải mua game á.
Thank you very much.
Okay, new man, well done. A very careful reading. And welcome to the room. Very nice indeed. Now, just that second sentence. With the white road smoking behind him and his rapier brandished. Notice it's brandished high. Otherwise, that was nicely done, and thank you. Lolo, it's your mic.
Hello? Can you hear me well? Okay. Beth, he's heard like a madman, shrieking a curse through the sky. With the white rose smoking behind him, and his rapier brandished high. Blood red were his spurs in the golden moon. Wine red was his velvet coat. When they shut him down on the highway, down like a dog on the highway. And he lay in his blood on the highway, with a punch of lace at his throat. Thank you.
Thank you, Lolo. Right, now just two words. Rapier. It's like a sword, okay? Sharp sword. And his rapier brandished high. Okay, and the other word I noticed was your pronunciation of the consonant letter B. It sounded more of a P, okay? At the end, right at the end, with a bunch. Okay, with not with a punch, with a bunch of lace at his throat. Okay, and thank you. Great reading, that one. Right, now there is the last verse, friends. And this entails the whole of the first verse again, actually. So, but it's a little bit more, a little spooky, okay. Yes, the P is aspirated, the B is not. You have to purse your lips. I know it's awkward. As though you're blowing through your lips. Puh, puh, like that. Puh. Okay. Right. It's an awkward little difference, okay. But you'll get it eventually, okay. And now, of course, this is all about ghosts. And still, of a winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees, when the moon is a ghostly galleon tossed upon cloudy seas, when the road is a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding. The highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door. Over the cobbles he clatters and clangs in the dark inn yard, and he taps with his whip on the shutters, but all is locked and barred. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting her, but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess. The landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. That's the last verse of the poem. It shows how Bess became a hero, a heroine, trying to save the life of the robber. Okay, hello, Woolly Tran, welcome to the room, friend. Right, the source of this passage, Lolo, is, let me write it. Okay, there it is. You can get it off the internet as well, I think. But I've had it for a long time. Okay, The Highwayman by Alfred Noyes. Okay, yes, of course. You just put your hand up. I see you've got it up already. Right. Now then, Chippendales, it's your time. Thank you.
All right, thank you. And still of a winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees, when the moon is a ghostly galleon tossed up on cloudy seas, when the road is a ribbon of a moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding. A highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door, over the cobbles, he clatters and clangs in the dark inn yard, and he taps with wet shutters. With all his locked and barred, he whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, bless the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. All right, guys, thank you.
Okay, Chippendale, very nice. Just one word. The word tune. Okay. The American English might say tune, but British English is tune. He whistles a tune to the window. Okay. Right, and thank you for that. Samurai, your mic.
Hi everyone, I will start with, and still of winter's night, they say, when the wind in the trees, when the moonlight is ghostly galleon, tossed upon cloudy seas, when the road is a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding. Highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door, over the cobble the clatters and clangs in the dark inn yard, and he taps with his whip on the shutters, but all is locked and buried. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but The Lord's black-eyed daughter, the Lord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Samurai. Just the 2 points, and they are, second sentence, when the moon is a ghostly galleon. Now you told us when the moonlight, okay, it's when the moon is a ghostly galleon. That was one. And the other little point was up to the old inn door. Remember the little rule, if you have vowel sound following the definite article, you change the to the. So it's up to the old indoor. Okay. Otherwise, thank you very much. I see. It's your mic.
Thank you, Starik, and hi, Gary, the reading. And still of a winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees and the moon is a ghostly galleon tossed upon cloudy seas, and the road is a weapon of moonlight over the purple moor. A highwayman comes riding. A highwayman comes riding up to the olden door. Over the cobbles he clatters and clangs in the darkened yard. And he taps with his whip on the shutters, but all is locked and barred. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter? Yes, the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. Thank you so much, Sarah. You might.
Thank you, I see. Well, that was a great reading. Very careful reading. Okay, very nice indeed. I have no corrections. Beautifully done. Thank you. Okay. So what was the question, Ramon? The old, yes, the. No, it's not. It's only the pronunciation. We don't use the. You see, well, we do use it occasionally in the as a pronoun. Okay. The and the definite article is not a pronoun, okay? It is the article, or it is an adjective. It is not the pronoun the, okay? But it sounds the same. But I mean, I would say to you, I would say, I like thy voice, okay? I like thy voice. I will give thee, that means I will give to you, I will give thee a prize, okay. So that's the old English that we occasionally use. I do it very occasionally. It's one of those things that come through with English, okay. But it's not the sort of language you would hear in the vernacular, okay. Right, thank you for that. That was nice. And very shortly, friends, I'll be leaving. Okay, so I'm going to pass the mic to Newman. It's your mic.
Thank you, Sir Starik, for explanation. Thank you very much. Please retype the text. Thank you very much. And still of winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees, when the moon is a ghostly galleon tossed up in cloudy seas, when the road is a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor. A highwayman comes riding. A highwayman comes riding up the old indoor over the cobbles. He clatters and clanks in the dark in yard, and he taps with his wipe on the shutters. But all is locked and Bart. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be wearing her bet? The landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess. The landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. Thank you very much for all.
Okay, thank you for that. Now, I'm about to leave, friends, and I see there's no other moderator in the room, so I'll leave my name here, and I'll be keeping an eye on things to make sure people don't misbehave, because we get some funny people now and again. So I'll be keeping an eye to make sure it remains safe for our young kiddies and all of you. In the meantime, friends, don't expect to hear from me, okay? So, Devlos Silva, it'll be your mic next. And can I thank you all for a very interesting afternoon, a few hours of your time in your participation in the grammar session and now in the reading session. It's been very interesting to me, and I hope it has been helpful to you, okay? Devlos Silva, it's your mic. And thank you, friends. Cheerio.
Thank you, Mr. Starik. And still of a winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees, when the moon is a ghostly galleon to lucid ample coolly seas, when the road is a ribbon of a moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding. A railwayman comes riding. The old indoor. Over the cobbles in the clavers and clangs in their dark. Sorry. Over the cobbles in the clavers and clangs in the dark in yards, and taps with his whip on the shutters, but the owl is locked and buried. He whistles and turns to window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess, the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark head love knot into her long black hair.
Hello? Hello, can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me now? Sorry. Okay. And still of a winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees, when the moon is a ghostly galleon tossed up on cloudy seas, when the road is a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding. Highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door. Over the cobbles he clatters and clangs in the dark inn yard, and he taps with his whip on the shutters, but all is locked and barred. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's daughter, Bess. Thank you. Mic is free.
Hello, can you hear me? Okay, thank you. Nice reading. Low, low. I will try to read, guys. And still of winter's night, they say, when the wind is the trees, when the moon is the ghostly galleon dusted upon cloudy seas, when the road is a ribbon of a moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding, riding, riding. A highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door, out of the cupboards. They clatter and clangs in the dark inn yard, and he taps with his whip on the shutters. But all is locked and buried. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's spare eye, black-eyed daughter's death. The landlord's daughter, plaiting in a dark red love knot in her long black hair. Thank you for listening, guys. The next reader. Anyone who could correct me is a great. I appreciate you to correct me. Okay? Mike, please. Okay, the next reader, Samurai, the Samurai, or Isaac Race.
Sorry everyone, I was busy passing. And still of winter's night, they say. When the wind in the trees, when the moon is ghostly galleon tossed upon cloudy seas, when the road is ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding, riding, riding. A highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door. Over the cobbles he clatters and clangs in the dark inn yard, and he taps with his whip on the shutters, but all is locked and buried. He whistles a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there but the land's black-eyed daughter, Piss. The landlord's daughter plaiting a dark red love knot into her black hair. Thank you for listening.
Okay, hello, room. I need to thank Starik for this nice exercise. Beginner, good to see you. How are you, beginner four? We've just finished the reading exercise, and it's beautiful. We've learned a lot, and I, for myself, have learned new words today thanks to Starik, and of course, no grammatical rules. One of these words that really, really intrigued me was there was a word let me check it out for you. Bird is a weapon of a purple moon, guns riding down at door clatters. Gap is wood in the shutters. There was a word, I don't recall the chapter actually in the excerpt, but there was a word, brandish high. Rapier. And the word brandish, wave or flourish, brandish.